What's up, everybody? Today we're gonna go over the item tier list for Pokemon Unite, and it took me a while to do this because I actually took some time to go through the items and level them up and see what they're really capable of. So now I'm gonna come back to this and I'm gonna go ahead and make this tier list, and this is all strictly my opinion. This is on the current update of the game, so let's get straight into this. All right, so the first item here is the AO's cookie, and this item does give you a lot of health when you do score goals. I'm not exactly sure what the highest number is. I do recall seeing about 400, but honestly, using this item, I don't think health plays a big factor right now into the game mechanics and you know, how the fights turn out. I really don't notice it at all, so I definitely say this is troll level. I don't see anyone really utilizing this or this being really viable for anyone, so troll level for sure. All right, next option here is the assault vest. I use this item a lot. It is really good to protect you from, you know, junglers just popping in your lane, you know, just sneak attacks, or just, you know, poking at an enemy and they might get a move off on you. It just negates a lot of damage. So I would say this is definitely one of the best choices to have. It's definitely something that's going to keep you alive and keep you in the fight. Next item here, the attack weight. It's really good if you want to stack some damage, although the damage isn't really as noticeable, but it's definitely noticeable is what I would say. I would say, you know, it's situational. It kind of depends if you just want to go straight full damage, but honestly I would say suboptimal, because damage isn't really, you know, the biggest factor in the game you should be focusing on. So put it right here at suboptimal. All right, the next item we have here is the buddy barrier. Buddy barrier gives you an ultimate to your lowest health ally and yourself, I believe, or gives you a shield once you use your ultimate. And I believe that this item is very, very, very good, especially for defenders or almost anybody, to be completely honest. That shield is just gonna help you out in that team fight, especially, and keep you guys alive. So I definitely say buddy barrier are the best choices right now in the game. The next one here is the eject button. Eject button is probably the most used item in the game. This item is, by, you know, obvious choice, one of the best choices. It gets you out of sticky situations. It's, you know, the flash of Pokemon Unite. It's just, you know, it's essential. It's definitely one of the best items in the game, 100%. This is the energy amplifier. It does give you some damage or extra attack when you do use your ultimate, and honestly I do notice the damage that you get from here. And as I said again, damage isn't really, you know, the most focus in this game, and I honestly say it is also suboptimal. This item isn't really gonna get you what you think it's gonna give you. You know, damage is going to be there, but at the same time, it's really just not the best item. All right, the next item we have here is the EXP share. I think the EXP share is very, very underrated. I use this on Blissey all the time. It really helps whoever else is in my lane get, you know, really leveled ahead. They're always usually up a level on, you know, the other team, which really helps in fights. So EXP share, I would definitely say it's situational, only if you're playing really hardcore support. That's pretty much it, but it is really situational, but it is a good, good item. Put that right over here. Floatstone. Floatstone is a really good item. I don't use it as much anymore. I used to. I would say it's really good for junglers. You know, you can use it to float around really quickly. You're not really floating, but, you know, you're moving really quickly. I definitely noticed the movement speed difference between having it and not having it on. So, you know, I definitely see the situation also. for junglers, and just to make sure you get into those lanes quickly to help out your team. The next item we have here is the Buzzy Tail. This is one of the items that you do take into the battles with you. It is used against other Pokemon that you find out in the wild. It's basically like the Smite in this game. It does have the same effect. It is pretty good. I do see a lot of people use it as of lately, but I don't really think, you know, it's necessary. You can definitely smite and get those, you know, quicker guarantees on wild Pokemon, but I just really think that it's not really the most necessary item. So I'd also put this at about situational level, because, you know, it's definitely good if you want to use it, you know, on a Zapdos or Dreadnought to make sure you can get that last hit and get the extra damage in. That's about it. So I'd say situational for sure. All right, the next item we have here is the Focus Band. Now, the Focus Band is, in my opinion, one of the best items in the game, and I use it for every single item build that I have. I don't know any Pokemon that I don't use a Focus Band on. Maybe Blissey, because I heal myself already so much, but this item is just crazy. I wouldn't be surprised if they end up patching this in the future. I wouldn't be disappointed if they did. But this item is just insane. It keeps you alive when you think you're gonna die. This is what really wins you fights here. But definitely one of the best choices right now in the game. Next item we have here is Full Heal. Full Heal, it does negate all of your status effects. I don't think no one's really gonna use this. It's really not the best item to have. I don't really think you would use this unless you plan on running away from a fight. And, like, you know, being stunned, you know, once you're really stunned, I don't think there's much you can do after that unless you believe you can really win the fight. So if you're using this, I'm assuming you want to run, and if you want to run, I'd rather just have a jump button. So yeah, I'm gonna put this at a troll level. I don't think this item is really gonna help you out much at all. All right, the next item we have here is Goal Getter. Now, Goal Getter, I honestly don't use it. I have used it a couple of times just to see what it was about, but I believe it has a pretty long cooldown, and just to get a quicker goal, it's not really, you know, the funnest item to use. So, you know, you don't really have those situations where it comes down to you coming neck and neck and you need that very last goal, you're able to get that quick score. You know, those neck and neck games come every once in a while, so usually they're blowouts. I'd really put this at a troll level. It's really not worth it here. All right, the next item we have here is Leftovers. Leftovers is a really good item, especially if you don't like recalling to your base. You can get some pretty good heals here, especially when your goals are taken down a lot. You don't want to run all the way back to your goal if you're pushed back, you know. So I would definitely say this here is a good option. Leftovers will definitely keep you in the fight. You know, if you want to go hide in the bush somewhere, you know, when Zapdos is up and, you know, they're close to getting it, but you're a little low on health, you want to stay back a little bit or something, you know, Leftovers is definitely good for that. It's definitely a good option. All right, so the next item here is the Muscle Band. The Muscle Band, in my opinion, is a very, very good item. It does increase the speed of your auto attacks and your auto attack damage. This item is definitely something that I would use, you know, on Cinderace or sometimes Machamp. I would definitely put this as a good option. It's definitely viable. You definitely notice the results when you put it on. It's really, really good item for sure. Solid. Next item we have here is a Battle Potion. And the Battle Potion, you know, it's okay. It doesn't give you the most heals. Honestly, as soon as you pop it, that health that you just gained is most likely going to be lost if you're in a real sticky situation. So honestly, I would definitely put this at about suboptimal level. It's not really going to give you the best healing effect, and if anything, your goal is going to heal you more than this ever can. So all right, Rocky Helmet. You know, a lot of people might disagree with me on this one. I know a lot of people used to use Rocky Helmet. I'm not sure if people use it anymore, but I just think that the damage that it puts out is really minimal, and it's just not worth it at all. I believe this gives you a health stat, It's not the highest health stat compared to other items, so Rocky Helmet, I definitely put it at a troll level. I don't like Rocky Helmet. I don't think you get any benefits out of it. So that's about it there. All right, the next item here is a scope lens. Now the scope lens is a really good item, especially when it's compared with the muscle band here. So definitely a good option. Combine these two and your auto attacks are definitely hitting way harder, crits faster, better base damage. And it's just the best of both worlds. You get it all with these two. Definitely a good combination. It's a good option. All right, the next item we have here is a score shield. Score shield is a really, really, really good item. A lot of junglers are starting to use this now. Just farm up and just go straight for scores, especially using Crustle. I definitely put this as one of the best choices. This item is really good for defenders, junglers, even laners. You know, if you're really an aggressive laner, you can always just go in there and get a goal in, you know. So definitely score shield, one of the best choices right now in the game. All right, shell bell. Shell bell is a very good item. It does give you some minimal health when you do use some skills. I wouldn't say it's the most health in the game, but it does definitely help if you're getting poked and, you know, you're just farming up some wild Pokemon. And you know, it gives you some heals just from farming up a little bit using your moves. So I definitely say this is a good option for sure. The healing is definitely noticeable. It's definitely gonna help you out and it procs all the time, you know. So as long as you have a move up, you're gonna get some heals. So definitely a good option. All right, slow smoke. Now slow smoke is a different item here. You know, I've seen people use it on me and it actually is very effective. And I don't ever use it myself, but from the times that it has been used on me, it is really hard, you know, to locate where the players are. So I definitely say this is situational because you can definitely get some good use out of this, as I fell for it multiple times before. So the next item we have here is a special attack specs. These do increase your special attack when you do score a goal. And honestly, I don't really see the most out of it. You know, you don't really get the most damage out of it. I think it's a little noticeable, maybe just a little bit with your skills, but honestly, it's something that I really wouldn't put on. As I said, damage isn't really the most prioritizing thing in this game right now, so I definitely say it's about suboptimal, but you can definitely use it and get some more damage out, you know, if you want to, but I wouldn't use it in my opinion. So all right, Wise Glasses here is the next item. Wise Glasses just increases your special attack. Now, Wise Glasses, it's not the worst item. It has some good stats with it also, but I don't think Wise Glasses is something that I put on most of the time. So I definitely put Wise Glasses as about a suboptimal level. Some people definitely use it. I know a lot of people use it, but I don't really notice the damage. And as I said over and over again, damage isn't something you should be prioritizing when it comes to items in this game. All right, the next item we have here is X Attack. What did I tell you about damage items? We don't really care. I'll put this at a troll level. I see nothing coming out of this item at all. And the very last item we have here is X Speed. And X Speed is very underrated. I believe X Speed is very good if you don't have Eject Button. This definitely got me out of so many situations before I had Eject Button. It's almost better because I believe you do run for it. You get a lot of speed. You get to run for a while. So I put this as a good option for sure. All right, that's pretty much it here for my tier list for the items here and the battle items. Tell me what you guys think. What you guys would change up, or if you agree with me, go ahead, hit that like button, hit the comment section, hit that subscribe button, turn the post notifications on. We're trying to get to 100 subscribers, and that's about it. I'll catch you guys later.